Hey everybody, welcome back to Bob Key TV, another stage in the books at the Vuelta a España, stage number 4, one of the very few sprint stages, and the sprint was won by Matteo Trentin, who was second on one of the other very few sprint stages, stage number 2, to his own teammate Yves Lampaert. Great sprint by Matteo Trentin. Follow the wheels was handed off by Yves Lampaert himself in the perfect spot in the last corner after a pretty brilliant lead out by the Quickstep squad. They have a very proficient, shall we say, way of doing the lead outs that leads to incredible amounts of success. The winningest team in professional cycling year in and year out. They have a pretty big budget, not as big as some of the juggernaut squads like BMC, Sky, but they do have great athletes that work very well together, and that makes a big difference in professional cycling. They sacrifice very willingly for each other, and that's a hard environment to cultivate on any professional cycling team. One rider gets the glory, but his teammates have to deliver him, whether it's a Grand Tour win, whether it's a Classic win, whether it's a stage at a Grand Tour, any race. You need the help of your teammates to win. A time trial is maybe the only exception, but just to get to the time trials in one piece is a challenge. So teamwork is critical in Quickstep, run by Patrick Lefebvre, one of the legendary team managers in cycling. He's been in the game since I was a pro, so that shows you how far back Team Quickstep and Patrick Lefebvre go. And Matteo Trentin, like I said, helped Yves Lampaert win stage number 2, get the leader's jersey, and then was repaid a couple of days later with a brilliant stage win. Was dropped off on the wheel of JJ Lobato from the Lotto Jumbo squad. Did a decent sprint, but Matteo Trentin followed the wheels brilliantly. Last 200 meters, hard left-hand corner, big wide boulevard, no question. No question about the winner, no question about any questionable tactics. Really, really cool to see Matteo Trentin get the win after sacrificing his chances to get the leader's jersey on stage number 2 to his teammate Yves Lampaert. And Quickstep, they have a way of doing that in all the races that they go to. So great to watch them race, the way they race, the way they do the lead outs, the way they help each other. And so when they're rewarded with success, it's pretty enjoyable. No change to the overall standings. Chris Froome, pretty reasonable day. No mechanicals, no splits, no time gaps, never had to close down any effort, didn't have to make any effort himself. The team was put under a little bit of pressure in the last 40 kilometers of the race. No sprint teams, no big sprinters, so no teams dedicated to ensuring that day in and day out there's a sprint stage, which takes a lot of pressure off of Team Sky during the Tour de France. So moving forward, what type of burden the leader's jersey is on Chris Froome's shoulder and his teammates will become self-evident in the many, many stages to go out of 21. We've only done 4, so a long, long way to go. A lot of hard stages to come. But today, Team Sky defended the race lead rather brilliantly. Tomorrow, a day for the breakaways, a really tough little kicker to the finish line. Category 3 climb, 3-plus kilometers, not super steep, but you better be on your best game. Not let any gaps open up in front of you between you and a rampaging Chris Froome thus far, or you're going to lose some more time. And I'm pretty much sure, I would be willing to wager that Chris Froome will try to get time on tomorrow's stage. That will provide us with a very exciting finale. And I do believe that breakaway will succeed. It's a perfect day for the breakaway to succeed. The GC is in perfect focus. Everybody knows what their place is. And as long as anybody in the top 15 riders or so does not try to find the early breakaway, I think the breakaway has a great chance of staying away on stage number 5. Tune into that tomorrow. Until then, best of luck out there. Hope everybody gets to enjoy some of their own miles at their own leisure. And follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Please subscribe. Please buy some merchandise if you'd like some Bob Key TV t-shirts. And please continue to bring the comments to me. Thanks a lot, everybody. Until tomorrow.